is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from the United Kingdom, the Specialist, Luke.
Ah, this place is coming alive now.
Of all the superstars on the roster, this guy is among the hardest working. That goes without saying.
And approaching the ring, from Aberdeen, Washington, weighing in at 210 pounds, Daniel Bryan.
Well, this superstar has all the tools needed to win this one. Now let's see if he can put them together.
You know you're a big deal when you host as many WrestleManias as Rosemont has. This city is so rich in wrestling history.
And approaching the ring, from Bray, County Wicklow, Ireland, weighing in at 190 pounds, the NXT Champion, Finn Balor.
What a reaction from the WWE Universe. I can't hear myself think.
This triple threat match can go any way. It's almost too close to call a favorite heading in. I would be remiss if I didn't mention, and it's important to remember amidst the chaos of a triple threat match, that victory can be achieved in many different ways, and there's nothing traditional about a triple threat match. Nice move. God, there was nothing accurate about that attempt at offense.
Oh, you're being too kind. Some people would use other words to describe what we just witnessed.
What do you think about Daniel Bryan?
This is a great opportunity to make a statement. Coming out on top of these two will do wonders for a career.
Look at this damage being delivered to the back. I have a strong feeling that these guys will throw caution to the wind and just go full steam ahead.
I hope you're right. That's exactly what I want to see. One of the famous periods of time from Daniel Bryan's career was when he was one half of Team Hell No. Even though sometimes they needed to hug it out, Daniel Bryan and Kane were tag team champions and one of the most famous teams in WWE history.
Look out!
Ouch! That'll give you a whiplash.
Folks, we're in Rosemont tonight, a city that has hosted several WrestleManias, including the second leg of WrestleMania 2. Very impressive.
Michael, thinking about Daniel Bryan and Kane, I think of all the great matches Team Hell No had, and well, sometimes the great arguments Daniel Bryan and Kane had with each other. Former WWE Tag Team Champions, they are one of the best teams in the modern era of WWE.
Bryan certainly had that one well scouted.
Yeah, that's because Daniel Bryan is so prepared every time he steps in the ring.
I've heard it from countless superstars over the years, including Stone Cold Steve Austin, that this arena in Rosemont is their favorite arena to compete in.
Perfectly executed.
Well, that missed him all right.
Hey, did you look before firing? What an idiot. Yep, there's the reversal by Finn Balor. And he's toast. I have never, in all my years in this business, seen a crowd react to a figure like they do Daniel Bryan. I mean, thunderous chants of yes, yes, yes. And now we have an entire movement on our hands here. It's called the Yes Movement, and it's unbelievable. Oh, incoming! Daniel Bryan, no problem getting out of that one. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
And his heartless attack continues.
Oh, man, this is getting tough to watch.
This is what makes him so dangerous. When this guy's on, look out. Look at Finn Balor here. Ken, you talked before about Daniel Bryan's amazing response from crowds all over the world. And, well, I'm not as old as you, but I'm going to say the same thing. You know, there it is, the pop-up powerbomb.
Oh, man, it's all over but the crying after that, Cole.
At this point, you think he'd have that move well scouted.
Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
Oh, wow.
Well, the trick sometimes when you get outside the ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous objects.
This is a wreck. He's moving like an uncaged animal.
Oh, my. He's wild in there. Timber! And he falls hard.
It's really amazing just the unrelenting crowd support Daniel Bryan enjoys wherever he goes. I know I haven't always been complimentary of him, but that was then and this is now. The yes chants in every arena we go to are deafening. Chants break out for him just at the mere mention of his name. We are, without a shadow of a doubt, in the midst of a movement, the Yes Movement.
Well, you got that right. Daniel Bryan's fan support is truly a phenomenon. People want to see Daniel at the very top of WWE. And this yes movement is going to be around for a long, long time, I believe. I just don't know where it's going to go next. I don't think anyone can predict that. Yep, there's the reversal by Finn Balor.
There's a term we've used in the business for a very long time. Simple yet effective.
This guy's just getting worn out. Finn Balor's coup de grace is quickly becoming one of my favorite signature moves in all of WWE. It's so simple, yet so effective. The end may be near.
Finn Balor scores with a tremendous move.
He's in trouble now.
From what we've seen and heard tonight, there must be serious injuries.
No kidding. This is going to need some serious medical attention. Finn Balor, totally vulnerable at this point. Achtung! There's the German suplex, Cole.
Are you from Berlin now?
Yes. Much more of that, and he's not going to last long.
I've called so many of Daniel Bryan's matches throughout his WWE career.
Daniel!
And a kick out.
And that's all that matters. This match continues.
There's no keeping this guy down tonight. This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
We're about to find out how much pain that shoulder can take.
A great streak of offense. You do anything you can for something to result in an advantage and ultimately victory.
Bryan certainly had that one well scouted.
Yeah, that's because Daniel Bryan is so prepared every time he steps in the ring. How much more are you willing to pay to win this match? This is unreal. It'll take a minor miracle to come back from this.
Oh, there it is. What a maneuver. That's how you put away an opponent. I love it.
Even if you can get back to your feet after a move like that, at this stage of the match, you're still struggling to find your balance. Wow! Unbelievable impact there.
Folks, we're in Rosemont tonight, a city that has hosted several WrestleManias, including the second leg of WrestleMania 2.
Finn Balor making a statement as we speak.
He doesn't want to do this outside the ring.
Well, I don't blame him. Keep the action inside the ring. That's where you're going to win this thing.
He's setting up.
Here we go. And he's in big trouble. Oh, what a slam. All these power moves tonight are making bigger and bigger impacts. Look at this. He's just barely moving. I'm not sure he can get back to his feet. He needs to dig way down deep if he wants to keep going now.
And once again, we see a return to the specific maneuver. Hey, whatever works.
Yeah, if it keeps working, keep working.
Nobody home there.
Nobody home? Cole, that looked like the house has been empty for months. Somehow, he's kicked it into another gear here tonight. Well, we're on the move here. Daniel Bryan, no problem getting out of that one. No, not again. Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
There's the suplex.
That was nice. Well, we're on the move here.
And there's the submission hold. Will this do it?
This is not the position you want to be in.
Watch it!
What strength! Fighting his way out.
Just making his presence felt there.
Well, the trick sometimes when you get outside the ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous objects.
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
No kidding, this is getting ugly.
Well, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you could find yourself in a world of hurt.
This one's not over yet. We've seen plenty of people come back from being in a lot worse shape.
Yep, there's the reversal by Finn Balor.
He gets
going for the cover.
One.
Wow, there's the save. The match continues. A fever pitch is here in the WWE Universe.
You're right about that. The crowd is buzzing. They're ready for this thing to get underway.
Extra slow getting back to his base here.
We're looking at complete domination here. Oh, I think this man means business.
Even if you can get back to your feet after a move like that, at this stage of the match, you're still struggling to find your balance. Uh-oh, he's in position, ready to strike.
Back where it belongs, inside the ring.
That's it, he's done.
There it is.
He thinks he has, and he escapes with a kick out. Can you believe the endurance of this guy? Can you believe what he's withstood here tonight? He lands the strike with great accuracy.
Oh, what a shot. That did some serious damage. You can't take too many of those and expect to be in the match much longer.
Boy, he just got laid out.
We know what's coming here.
Hey, he's going for it again.
There it is, the pop-up powerbomb.
Oh, man, it's all over, but they're crying after that, Cole.
Hey, suplex.
Daniel Bryan with the quick cover.
One. They're still alive.
Yeah, Cole, you remember that song back in the day? Staying alive? Well, that was it in WWE terms.
Finn Balor going high risk.
This match has taken
the coup de grace is going to be the coup de grace.
Does the coup de grace mean this thing's over?
I don't believe it. He refuses to lose. I've heard it from countless superstars over the years, including Stone Cold Steve Austin, that this arena in Rosemont is their favorite arena to compete in. Back in the ring now.
Yeah, let's just see how long they can keep it in the ring.
And now he goes for it a second time. Oh, they couldn't find a home for that one. A nailing kick combo. Daniel Bryan is closing the damn door.
That's right, Daniel Bryan looking close to victory here.
Check that out. That's how effective offense can be when you're able to combine moves together.
He needs to dig way down deep if he wants to keep going now.
His shoulders are down.
Two.
Three. He did it. What a huge win.
Oh, they threw everything they had at each other in this match. Oh, boy. That was a spectacular performance. You want to talk about crowd pleasing? Look at this.
This was a match that was simply mesmerizing.
Here's your winner, the Specialist, Luke.
Now that's eking out a win. I don't think Finn Balor is used to losing like that. Wow. And folks, I am happy to report that this triple threat match we just saw is now trending worldwide.
Welcome back to the show. This is my guest tonight. Let's talk about what happened out there tonight. The Authority has been very active lately. Do you have any thoughts on them?
The Authority runs this place, and I'm glad they do. Without them, the WWE would fall into pieces. If they ever need more help, I'm here. They just better throw something my way, if you know what I mean.
There you have it. Back to you guys.
following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring from the United Kingdom, the Specialist, Luke.
Man, both of these teams are determined to walk away with a win. Something's got to give.
Looking motivated to make an impact here tonight.
And his tag team partner, from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing in at 255 pounds, the game, Triple H!
Man, the tag team scene has been on fire of late here in WWE, and I think we're about to see another hot one. And these teams have been waiting for this one, and so have I.
And their opponents, Connor and Victor, the Ascension.
Oh, the referee will undoubtedly have his hands full when these two teams collide.
Tremendous tag team competition coming up here. And here we go. This tag team match is going to be heated, to say the least.
We have tag team action that's just underway here, and both of these teams look ready to go. This is so intense, we might see an explosion here tonight.
The human body can only absorb so much of that. This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
I certainly didn't expect to see this kind of damage.
Definitely looking good so far. Hasn't taken too much punishment up to this point.
Oh. looking to be in great physical condition here, almost impervious to pain. We're in the feeling out process. Who's going to get the advantage and maintain control?
Your guess is as good as mine, Cole.
Can you imagine what it must be like to be on the receiving end of a Connor diving shoulder block?
Wow, what impact.
Going to the top, high risk.
Oh!
Looking highly motivated here. The damage has been done. Everything Connor does delivers a great impact, Kang. How about that flapjack?
Yeah, we've seen him rearrange a few faces with that move over the years, Cole. Really pushing his opponent to the limit here.
Look at the attack here.
Oh, man. Talk about a direct hit.
Another great tag team match here tonight. I don't think the tag team scene has ever been hotter here in WWE. Dishing out some serious punishment here.
Man, he's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got serious. Seriously wrong there.
And Victor gets driven to the mat.
Ouch, did you see the way his head bounced on impact? Look out.
You have to wonder what's going through these guys' minds in a match of this magnitude. Going for the cover.
One, two. We've got everybody going at it now. Whoa! Don't get up! And there's the count. Look at this! This could be it!
And this heartless attack, it's gotta be over now.
Looking for all the glory here. Spectacular match. Oh, they threw everything they had at each other in this match.
Here are your winners, the Specialist, Luke, and the Game, Triple H.
You want to talk about a tag team war? We most definitely witnessed just that. This was from bell to bell, a clinic in tag team wrestling. Kudos to everyone.
I love tag team matches, and that was one of the best I've seen in a while. Man, you can bet there's gonna be a celebration tonight.
As hard as it will be not to think about that amazing match we just saw, we might. collar and elbow tie-up here.
This is critical for a competitor in establishing themselves in the match.
And the turnbuckle does the damage.
Detroit has had the reputation for being an electric crowd. The fans here in attendance tonight are indeed no different.
Looking fresh right now, which is good. You gotta wonder how much longer that can last, though.
Not today, too fast.
And he fails to connect with anything that time.
Man, that was some miss, all right. I could feel the breeze all the way over here. I think I saw a tooth fly out.
It's no surprise that someone the likes of Dean Ambrose would utilize a lethal maneuver like his Dirty Deeds finisher.
Oh, it's awesome.
Both of these competitors have so much resolve, it's going to take a minor miracle to keep one of them down.
Doing a number now.
He's endured heavy blows here. I don't know how much longer he can go. The referee may have to call this match, King.
Oh, my gosh, this is awful. I'm going to tell you something. Whenever you get hit like that, for the next 15 minutes, everybody you see has an exact win. Michael, you mentioned Dean Ambrose and his Dirty Deeds finisher. It looks like a descendant of the DDT. When Ambrose nails an opponent with that, you can hear everyone in the arena gasp at the same time. That move's annihilating.
He may be in the best physical condition I've ever seen him in.
Here's the cover.
One, two, and it's up. He got the shoulder up.
Well, like him or not, you won't beat Dean Ambrose like that.
And it's Dean Ambrose able to break free. Looks like he's pinpointing the back.
It only takes a couple of those to bring his night to an end.
When you think of the time Dean Ambrose took to create his offensive armory, if you will, the Dirty Deeds is a finisher.
The shoulders are down!
Plenty of fight left.
You're right. This guy's still near 100%. Oh, wait. Nice reversal. We know what this is.
There it is, the pop-up powerbomb.
Oh, man, it's all over but the crying after that, Cole. Dean Ambrose is not going to go away that easy.
Oh, wow. Detroit has had the reputation for being an electric crowd. The fans here in attendance tonight are indeed no different. In the mid-2000s, Dean Ambrose became known on the independent wrestling circuit for taking and dishing out ungodly amounts of punishment. To fans around the world, Ambrose emerged in 2012 as the eccentric leader of the Hounds of Justice, known as The Shield.
Oh, Ambrose emerged as the leader of The Shield, all right. When they arrived in WWE, the Hounds of Justice planned and carried out vicious attacks on all of WWE's most beloved heroes.
On, look out.
Wow, he's still down after that. When he gets going like this, there are a few better.
Well, this
great counter. Oh! And that'll give you a negative attitude. Look at him, Michael. I mean, those moves have really started to add up.
Looking to build momentum.
Watch it, watch it.
Whoa, whoa!
There it is, the pop-up powerbomb.
Oh, man, it's all over but the crying after that, Cole.
What do you have to do to keep this guy down?
to see it?
Great move! What a move!
Oh, that's gotta hurt, though.
Oh, man, there's the finisher.
Can he score the pin?
Two, three.
You know, Michael, we've talked about
the win. Man, he's gotta feel great.
Oh, those WWE competitors.
Oh, they threw.
Oh, what a
spin. They mesmerized it.
Here's your winner.